Okay, we've left the sample just in the room now, and the temperature's gone up to, we've just stirred it, the temperature's gone up to about minus 0.2, so it's still below freezing. You can see we've still got solid lumps in here. I'm just going to do the harrowing trick. Now bear in mind, your trap wouldn't be as wet as this because the water is not draining, there is no drainage in my Chinese takeaway dish. So we still have plenty of lumps in that. I'm beginning to wonder about the whole practicalities of adding salt in water to defrost a track or brine. We've already established that you need 5% salt by weight of water in the track to protect down to minus 1.6 degrees. Now, if you work out that a track is roughly, say, 400 meters long, 4-inch depth of sand, 12 foot wide, say, I stand to be corrected on any of these figures, 12 foot wide is 3.6 meters, 4 inches is 10 centimeters, 0.1 of a meter. That gives you a total volume of sand on your track of 144 cubic meters. 1 cubic meter of sand weighs about 1.5 tons, so that works out to 216 tons. Now we know that sand holds in amongst the particles roughly 25% of its weight as water, so that means the water that's already on your track is going to be about 54 tons, and if you're starting with no salt in that, you need to aim to get a 5% salt concentration. So that means if you're adding 10% salt, you need to add 54 tons of water to your track. If you imagine a large bowser might hold 8 tons of water, that's going to be over 6 bowsers worth of brine you've got to put on your track just to get the concentration of salt in the water on the track up to 5%. So the practicalities of actually using brine, even if it did defrost your sand better, are not that easy. And it does look as though brine doesn't really give you an advantage in terms of defrosting your sand there. This is still got plenty of frozen lumps in it, even though it's now warmed up in the room there to be not much less than freezing temperatures. So I think once again you've got to come back to the message there that once your track is frozen, you're going to have a lot of trouble defrosting it, and you might as well give up, really. Okay, on that depressing note,